Hello all, I am Professor Vaishali Shevale from Department of Computer Science, Ketecham College, Nasik. I welcome all the students of MSc Computer Science. I am going to teach you the subject Web Frameworks. The paper is paper 2. First of all, we will see the examination scheme for this paper. The course code is CSUT 233. There are 4 credits for this course. Internal will be of 30 marks and university examination will be of 70 marks. So total 100 marks are allotted for this course. And for web framework practicals, there are 4 credits again. Internal assessment is of 30 and university examination will be of 70 marks. So total 100 marks are allocated for this course. Now we will see the detail of the syllabus of web frameworks. The prerequisite for this course is you should have the basic knowledge of JavaScript. You should know the basics of web application development and the knowledge of client and server side programming. The main objective of this course is to introduce the students for modern web technologies, to learn and use server-side programming using Node.js, to understand asynchronous programming, to learn and understand web application in Django, a Python web framework. The outcome of this course is, after the completion of this course, the students will be able to know the powerful way to develop a web application in Python. Then students will be ready with the technology which is used widely in industry as a part of full stack developer. Students will understand what really is the asynchronous programming. They will be able to build and deploy robust Django web application. They will be integrated with RESTful web services. Now there are various topics. So the first topic is JavaScript basics. Second topic is introduction to Node.js. Third chapter is related to Node.js modules. In this, we are going to consider function, buffer, core module, local module, that are the various types of module, directories as a module, module exports, etc. In the fourth chapter, we are going to consider NPM, that is Node Package Manager. So what is NPM, that we will see. Then installing the package locally, updating the package, managing the dependencies, etc. In fifth chapter, that is web server, we are going to create a web server. Then we are going to handle various HTTP requests, then sending the request, etc. In next chapter, that is file system, we will consider file system model, then how to read and write the files, reading and writing directories, other file operations we will see. In the next chapter, that is 7th chapter, we will consider the concept of events, asynchronous JavaScript events, then asynchronous control flow with callbacks, what is promises, etc. In next chapter, that is working with databases, we will see connection string, MongoDB, working with the select command. Next chapter, Express.js. So introduction of Express.js. Routing, responding, receiving data, etc. So up to 9 chapters, we have the details about Node.js and JavaScript. From 10 chapter onwards, we have Django. So what is Django? That is a Python framework. Django MVT, how to get and install Django. In next chapter, getting started with Django. So 3 core files that we are going to consider: setting the database connection, managing users, and Django admin tools. We are going to install and use out of the box Django features. In next chapter, that is Django URL patterns and views, we will see generic views and designing a good URL schema. In next chapter, Django forms, classes, validation, authentication, etc. we will see. This slide gives the various reference books, so you can refer them for for your further studies. We will start with the chapter first, that is JavaScript basics. First of all, we will consider what is JavaScript. So JavaScript is lightweight interpreted programming language. It is designed for creating network-centric applications. It is a programming language for creating web pages interactive. The word interactive is important. So it is very easy to implement because it is integrated with HTML. It was created to make web pages alive. The programs in this language are called as scripts. One more important thing you remember is that JavaScript is not Java. They both are completely different. So JavaScript uses events and actions to make your page interactive. It is not Java. So Java, as you know, is an object-oriented programming language. JavaScript code is run on browser only. Remember this another difference. While Java creates application that runs in a virtual machine or browser. Consider various features of JavaScript. First of all, it is fully integrated with HTML or CSS. JavaScript helps you to create really beautiful and fast websites, supported by all major browsers. It is one of the three languages all web developers must learn. First is HTML for defining contents of web pages. What you want in your web pages, that will be defined by HTML. CSS will specify the layout of web pages, and JavaScript for programming the behavior of web pages. Now, what is JavaScript data types? So first of all, data type is nothing but it specifies what kind of data can be stored and manipulated within a program. JavaScript provides with different types of data for holding different type of values. There are two important data types in JavaScript, that is primitive and non-primitive data type. So you have to use where to specify data type. It can hold any type of values like numbers, strings, etc. For example, if I say where a is equal to 100, it means that 100 as a number will be stored in variable a. If I say where b is equal to Sam, so it means Sam as a string will be stored in variable a. As we have seen, there are two basic data types in JavaScript, that is primitive and non-primitive. Primitive data types are again divided into five data types. These are string, number, boolean, undefined, and null. String means sequence of characters. For example, if I write the word computer in double quotes, so it is nothing but it is a sequence of characters. So it has given one string. Next is number. As the name suggests, it will represent numeric value. For example, 10. Next is boolean. Boolean means it will represent the value which is either false or true. Undefined means it will represent undefined value. And null means no value at all. Then we have non-primitive data types, which are again divided into three types. First one is object. It represents instance through which we can access the members. Array is nothing but group of similar values, and regexp, that is nothing but it will represent regular expression. Now we will see each data type in detail with more and more examples. So the first data type is string data type. So the string data type is used for representing textual data, that is sequences of characters. Strings are created by using single or double quotes surrounding one or more characters. For example, if we write where a is equal to in single quote web, so we have used single quotes, and in where b is equal to double quotes web, so here we have used double quotes. So both representations are valid. Second is number data type. So the number data type is used for representing any positive or negative number with or without decimal place, or numbers written using exponential notation. For example, 1.5e minus 4 is equivalent to 1.5 into 10 raised to minus 4. Another examples are, if we write where a is equal to 100, means integer number is stored, and if we put decimal point, so it will give floating point number. For example, where b is equal to 100.5. If we divide any number by 0, then output will be infinity. For example, if we divide 16 by 0 or minus 16 by 0 or 16 divided by minus 0, so it will give you the output as infinity. Another representation is NaN, that is nothing but not a number. NaN means not a number value. For example, if you try to divide some text by some number, so it will give the output as NaN, that means not a number. Next data type is Boolean data type. So Boolean data type can hold only two values, that is true or false. It is used for storing the values like yes, that is true, or no, that is false. So examples are like this. You can store a true value in flag this way, where flag is equal to true. You can use Boolean data type for comparison between two operators. For example, if we have stored 2 in A, like where A is equal to 2, B is equal to 5, C is equal to 10. And if we give the comparison, if B is greater than A, so this is a true, so output will be true. If we say B greater than C, then output will be false. Next data type is undefined data type. So the undefined data type can have only one value, the special value undefined. So if a variable has been declared but it has not assigned any value, so that can be called as a undefined value. For example, here we have defined two variables A and B. We have not stored any value or assigned any value for variable A, so A is undefined. So we have defined this way, where A, then where B is equal to hello world. If we say alert A, so output will be undefined because we have not assigned any value to A. If we say alert B, so the output will be hello world because we have stored hello world in variable B. Next is null data type. This is another special data type that can have only one value, that is a null value. Null value means that there is no value. Remember that it is not equivalent to empty string or zero. It is simply nothing. A variable can be explicitly emptied of its content, current contents, by assigning it null value. For example, if we say where A is equal to null and alert A, so the output will be null, right? If you say where B is equal to hello world and alert B, so output will be hello world, because in the variable B we have saved the string hello world. Next is object data type. So the object is complex data type that allows you to store collection of data. Object contains the properties and it is defined as a key value pair. A property key is always a string, remember this, but the value can be any data type like string, number, boolean, or complex data type like arrays, function, and other objects. For example, if we say where person is equal to name colon Sam, surname colon Kent, age colon 40, means what? the key value pair will be this way: name is equal to Sam, surname is equal to Kent, age is equal to 40. So in this case you can say that key is what? Name, surname and age, and their respective values are Sam, Kent and 40. Second, where char is equal to model BMW color colon white doors colon 5. Now you may omit the quotes around the property name if the name is a valid JavaScript name as shown below. For example, you can say where char is equal to model colon BMW. So here we have omitted the double quotes in model because it is a valid JavaScript name. Same way, color colon white. So we have omitted the double quotes in color. Next is array data type. So array is nothing but a type of object used for storing multiple values in single variable. Each element in the array has numeric position and it is called as an index, and it may contain data of any data type: numbers, strings, booleans, functions, objects and even other arrays. Array index always starts from 0 so that the first element of the array is array of 0 and not array of 1. The simplest way for creating the array is by specifying the array elements as a comma separated list and enclosed by square brackets. For example, if we say where colors is equal to in square brackets red, yellow, green, orange. So what we have done here, we have created array named colors and we have stored various colors. Second, where cities is equal to in double quotes London, Paris, New York. If we say alert colors of 0, so what will be the output? Output is red. If we say alert cities of 2, so the output will be New York because the array index starts from 0. Next is about regular expression. So it is defined by using regexp. So regular expression is an object that describes a pattern of characters. JavaScript regular expression class represents regular expressions, and both string and regular expression define methods that use regular expressions to perform powerful pattern matching and search and replace functions on given text. The syntax is given as below: where pattern is equal to new exp, that is regular expression, in bracket pattern comma attributes. So attributes may be any of the three values like small I, g or m. So it specifies I means insensitive, case insensitive, G means global and M means multi-line matches. Thank you.